That's good dick.
I'm sorry, what?
I said, that's good dick, but in like a funny way.
Oh.
I want the first thing to come out of his mouth is just...
Okay, I'll cut it from the last part.
And at least I'm true to my word. Standing on the beach tops, waiting for the sun drops. Never gonna regret looking at this dead fish.
Isn't sun drop a soda?
I think so.
It's a good one. Don't not.
Scream your heart.
Stranding. I haven't heard anything about that guy since the cell phone up the butt incident.
Yeah. He's a bad boy.
Yeah, he's like the worst boy.
I don't know. I feel like Hitler was a worst boy.
I mean,
Stalin's a worst boy. Mao's a worst boy. James Card's a worst boy.
Whoa.
He's probably raped someone.
Even in fucking North Korea, they're condemning James Card.
Yeah, he's just like, we don't like Thai food.
Wait, I want to watch a movie with you.
Ah, you broke my arm.
I'm sorry.
Now I'm going to cough on my hand.
Oh, in that case, I'll dump it into your hand then.
Hi, my name is Margaret Thatcher.
Why are you wearing black now?
Because I'm crying.
Why are you wearing red again?
Because I'm not crying now. Hope no one cries.
No, but she's got tears in her eyes.
Come back, Sam. Don't tell me where to fucking come. I'm not coming on your back. That's gross. We're brother and sister.
I wonder if that was like part of the promotional material or something. Where she was in the black. I don't understand why that happened just now.
Just like that? Where she's black again?
Or maybe that's it. There's so much surreal bullshit going on. It's like, what is even happening?
So, because she's on the beach, she can't age. So those whales are on the beach. Does that mean they can't age?
I guess so.
Why does he keep getting tied to the bed? Is it so he doesn't go anywhere?
I don't know. Because that would be really annoying. Having to sleep on just one side the whole time.
Yeah.
Are your feet still all fucked up?
I'll check.
Nope. Should have a monster, dude.
You, man, I'm just looking at your dick. Fuck. Oh. Fucking asshole. Maybe, is it feet pics? Is that better? No, he probably doesn't give a shit about feet. I can examine my figurines. Yeah, I get it. Fuck. Cool. Let me drink a monster. Gotta get hydrated.
Yeah, the best thing to do is have a monster. You can have three of them.
I have three. I can have three. I can't have any more.
You can have all of them, but they do. It does give you a benefit, but after three, it doesn't do anything.
Okay.
He just fucking downs it too, man.
I know a couple of people that do that. Okay. Oh, I get a little extra stamina.
Mm-hmm.
Give me this bullshit. Like, these are rookie numbers. Look how long it takes him to drink this, motherfucker. Fuck yeah. Alright, one more time. Can I skip this one now?
Normally the animations are different. Yeah, if you press options, you can skip it.
Skip that.
There are different animations that you get, though.
Alright, drink my...
Three monsters, you would die. Anything with an exclamation point you have to do, I guess. So everything.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna use the toilet.
Are you taking a pee or a poo?
I'm gonna shit my britches.
Sam Hartman here. Research devoted to uncovering the secrets of the beaches and the best travel, as well as those of dunes and patrons. When you produce a certain amount of chiral matter is flushed from the system, chiral matter can adversely affect hormone secretion and nervous function. There's a correlation between exposure and the development.
Can you stop talking? So I can take a shower? Because after you poop, you have to take a shower every time. Oh my god, just fucking.
I like how the cans are in there.
Yeah. You good? Finally. Yeah, I'm not gonna take a shower. I don't feel like
wasting my time. You eat it for a while. I don't want any more.
Yeah, you do.
I mean, I do, but just know you eat it for a bit.
Hey there. Hollywood Mac. Nope. I oversee delivery operations as well as maintenance and repairs.
What'd you do?
I just hit circle.
I'm Mama.
Oh.
Those there are strands. Not just used for packing, by the way, but for identification, too. Take a closer look and see the record.
Okay, cool.
I don't know why they have these here, because you can't use any of them.
Nice.
Only the blue one at the end.
Alright, activate the turn. Cool.
Tutorial shit. Tutorial shit. Most of these are things that have been popping up on the screen already.
Yep. Just gonna get rid of all these fucking things.
Yeah, you don't have to read them. Tutorial shit. It's like Bill Nye.
I miss Bill Nye. He was a science guy.
Check on your equipment and the bibble.
So, Bibble?
Sam, this is Deadpool. I calibrated your BB based on physiological data we collected from you earlier. It's still just the best guess, though. After you take it out for a spin, we can check if you're in sync and tweak the BB sensitivity as needed.
What does that mean? You don't get to use any of the other ones. You can change the color of your stupid looking sunglasses.
I like the purple.
You can change the lens color too.
Yeah, black. Okay.
They have to hold, go back, and then hit hold X, I guess, or go down. Yeah, there you go. All right.
Cool.
Change the color scheme of your dumb glasses.
Alright.
So I'm done that. After you've done everything, what else do you have to do? Nothing? I think you can leave now. If you look to the right, there's a door there. Leave right room. There you
go. Oh, it's Vader!
Vader?
Yeah, Darth Vader.
I think what over?
Chock full of Hyrelium, but safe for you dudes guys to wear. That's all you'll need to go forth and reconnect the world. To make us whole again. I'm a porter. You're not connecting anything. Or maybe not. But I'll do what I have to help Amelie out.
It'd be pretty cool to have a floating, little crystal necklace.
Yeah.
Definitely have, some conversation starter. Mm-hmm. Oh, so it, like, it anti-gravity or something? No, it's cursed.
It's full of Kyrelium.
Oh.
Listen up, Sam.
No.
The terminals Amelie's people built in the towns and cities they pass through on their journey west are called...
No. Armpit here. Oh, my ankle.
The infrastructure's there, but the chiral network is offline. Right now, it's only capable of transmitting voice communications. Sometimes wired, sometimes wireless, and a small amount of data.
Data.
So, unless the necessary data stored on site, our chirograms won't show up.
Why do they need to show up, though?
The bridges members you've seen around the place are grams generated.
Why does that matter?
All you've got to do is find the knot, connect your cupid, and bring Cairo Communications online. Once you connect it to the terminal, you'll be able to initiate zero-time massive data transmission with the UCA network. Just like that, you'll reconnect us not only to each other, but to our past.
So you can see how this game is a little... it does take a while to get into because you've played the game for a total of 20 minutes,
yeah.
And there's been so many cutscenes right up front. The rest of the game doesn't have that long of cutscenes until the very end.
And then it's cutscene heavy again.
Yeah, the cuts the last 2 to 3 hours of the game are just cutscenes in typical Kojima fashion, but they're good. They're good cutscenes.
What am I beating? Is it this baby?
Reconnecting America.
Oh, you've been here the whole time?
Yeah. Well, I could 3D print a fucking textbook.
I'm gonna 3D print textbooks and put the college textbook thing out of business.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Before and after we're made whole, we'll need men in the middle.
No less. Suck in the middle. Here I am, suck in the middle.
Yeah, well, I don't have to know that.
What does that mean?
We'll give you the details at the dispatch there.
You know what they say? Idle hands and all that.
These shoes look like they've done some serious harms. Shall I dispose of them?
Wait. Hold on. There's something I want you to look into. My blood seemed to set those things off. Happened more than once.
Set them off? How do you mean?
I don't know. You took my blood, didn't you? You tell me.
All right. I'll see what I can do.
It's funny. funny, my two fetishes are feet and blood.
I love me some bloody feet.
You should have seen them earlier. I was surprised your feet were fucked up.
Yeah.
I wasn't expecting them to be.
Oh, fuck, why am I awake again? What? Is this Pup-Pup?
Yeah. It's Mads. Shut up, I'm trying to sleep.
So do I see those, like, little thingies also?
Like, does Norman Reedus see them?
Yeah.
I think so, yeah.
What am I going to do? Your current objective is to extend the contact network from here
to Fort Knot City. Don't think you can make me. He covers up his groin.
I don't get it.
Yeah, the symbolism is very on the nose. That's kind of Kojima for you, though.
So, take on orders. Orders for Sam. Smart drug delivery.
So you gotta take that shit to the weigh station.
Okay. Less than 50% damage. I think I can do that.
Yeah, just don't fall down a bunch. Yeah, so that'll show you, like, some of the hazards that you might come across when you're going, like, to the destination. So the first one is BTs, the second one I think is, like, steep inclines or mountains. The next one I think is cliffs, and then the last one's the rivers.
Okay, and then there's probably ladders and ropes.
That's something that you should bring, yeah, or, like, something that you might need.
Okay.
I typically don't pay attention to any of that, but that's just me. Yeah. And usually I just hold X and it'll load everything. The game is pretty, so they're providing you with stuff the first time.
Oh, fuck.
Oh. But I gotta show you that. Make it
triangle. I'm sorry, what?
If you hit triangle, it'll auto-range everything. Triangle. So that way it makes you, like, the most balanced.
Triangle.
So everything's attached to your suit instead of on your back.
Nifty.
The auto-arrange pretty much just means that, it's going to make you the most balanced.
Okay. See you later, fuckwads.
And then if you want to use anything, you hold right on the D-pad, and that'll bring up, like, the wheel.
Yeah.
And if you want to equip your sunglasses, you can hold up. And then hit X to wear them, and now you got your purple sunglasses on.
I'll style them. Alright, so I got climbing, ladder. Pee. Ooh, I got a lot of pee, and I thought I peed earlier, but apparently I didn't. Oh, I can't just pee at the... No bullshit. I'll wait until I get outside, then. God.
does he run so slow?
Because he's carrying a lot of gear.
Alright. So like they're trying to be realistic.
Uh-huh. So you can leave messages and shit, too, if you want.
I'm not going to.
I didn't really either. I think I left maybe 2 or 3 messages in the whole game. So over the course of, like, going there, like, there's that lost cargo again. Like, you can see that right there.
Yeah.
And it tells you where its, like, destination is. So Capital Knot City is where you just were. However... So if you want to get the full amount of likes from those, you have to take it to the destination, but you can also just take it to the distribution center you're going to, and you'll still get likes for it, but you'll get less.
Okay.
So, typically what I would do, if I were you, don't worry about getting the Capital Knot ones, because you're not going back to Capital Knot right now. I wouldn't worry about the Capital Knot ones, because you're not going that way. But if you find any that are going towards your destination, then pick those up. Okay, so any that say anything that says distribution center, you can get rid of those other waypoints too. Going to the incinerator, they're still there. There's really no like, you don't ever have to actually pee in the game. It's just something you can do.
Look how big that mushroom is.
I know.
And I ain't talking about the ground mushroom. You know what I mean? Alright, how do I get rid of these?
If you just hold square, it'll get rid of all of them. But you have to put the other one back on that you want to go to the other thing. The distribution center one.
Okay. Okay.
So, shut up! The neat thing in this game, too, is like the. Pretty much anywhere you can see, you can go, for the most part.
Yeah.
There are definitely some limitations to that, but. I remember there were plenty of times where I'm like. That looks like a skyboxy sort of thing, but it ends up not being a skybox. Like, you actually go all the way to certain locations. Then why not just say that? Yeah, just scan all the time.
Is this?
You can't get those yet. They're materials for later.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, if you want to get the Capital Knot ones, you can, but I'm just saying, like, you get more likes if you take them to the actual destination as opposed to taking, like, dropping them off somewhere.
I'll just leave them.
So what ends up happening, too, in the game is, like, each of, like, the different places you deliver to has a different person at each one, and they have, like, what they're called connection levels.
Mm-hmm.
So you can, like, level up their connections. The more you deliver stuff to them.
For you.
And I recommend trying to get them up as much as you can because they do give you upgrades for that sort of stuff. Like more materials and certain ones will give you special equipment and stuff. Yeah, you don't need to make a ladder yet though.
Yeah.
So those things there are the post boxes that I was telling you about.
Okay.
So you can check them if you want. There might be some stuff in there, but I don't know if there is. Shut the fuck up. Yes. Yes, Timefall will eat away at the stuff that you're carrying.
What's this?
That's just a marker saying that it's gonna... that this area is prone to rain or Timefall.
Okay. What's this thing?
That's the post box. So if you activate it, you can see if there's anything in there. Which there might be. There might not be. I don't remember. So yeah, if you put something in the private locker, then it's only in this post box. You can only pick it up there.
Your private locker. Okay, I get it, guys. Cool. There's nothing to take out.
But if you want to put shit in there, you could.
Not going to. Why so many cat all not sitting ones? Damn.
I don't know.
What's this? Am I late? What? What is happening? Oh, okay, I see. It's saying that they're showing up now?
Yeah.
Cool.
Which I'm pretty sure you could have avoided this area altogether if you went up over that, like, big hill that was there.
Yeah.
If you used your climbing gear. That's what I did when I first played this part. But the easier terrain has BTs in it.
Uh-oh.
It's coming at you.
Yeah, excuse me, guys. Excuse me. I'm just gonna...
One thing that's actually, I haven't mentioned it, is like, certain things like this they don't tell you about. If you have a light enough load, and if you're sprinting, and you jump, you can actually do a double jump.
Nice.
So, like, if you, you know, double tap X when you're running, and if you, again, if you're light, you have to be light enough. You can't have that heavy, like, too much heavy stuff on. Otherwise, you will not be able to do it. Yeah, we'll stay there. There you go. Yeah, there's not that many. So, the game starts off pretty simply like this, where you're just kind of running from one place to the next. Excuse me, like, there's not that much as far as, like, mechanics are concerned, but, like, excuse me, as the game goes on, there's definitely more options for you to kind of take in situations like this.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, it starts off a little bare bones, but it definitely, like, opens up a little bit, like, more. Shut up.
Bitch.
Yeah, when that happens, hold both shoulder buttons to keep you.
Shut up, baby.
And to keep your balance. There's no way to turn those off. I wish there was. Because after a point, after you, like, know the game, like, you want to not have that come up. But, like, it always comes up.
I'm climbing up this mountain. I'm gonna make it my betcha. There we go. And now I'll rest for a hot second.
I don't look at you, gaming.
Yes. What's that?
Goobies.
Goobies. Give me that gooby. I'm gonna eat you.
I love it. I was swimming in raw sewage. I love it. Whoa. Another good way to like regain your balance is to crouch if that happens.
Makes sense.
Yeah. Well.
No. How smart are they? Yep. I see he's got a Christmas hat.
Oh, he does, doesn't he? That's funny.
It's not Christmas yet.
You can tell when we're playing this game. You can actually get a Christmas hat in the game.
Probably
or a Santa hat. No. Oh.
Yeah. Never even felt.
Except maybe one time. No, never no. mind. Not the one time. No, never mind.
No falls. Only 10%. You know, ain't nothing but a thing.
Whoa, you got a fucking ass, dude.
Whoa. Whoa to you, out earth and fire. Nope.
Dead. Caught in the void out.
That one blast out of all. And what they just sent you out on your own.
Sure.
I mean, if it was just a delivery, that'd be one thing. Porters come.
I always thought, too, like, it'd be kind of neat in this game if you could actually, like, go to the cities that you like actually deliver to, because they're pretty much like all the same. Every time you go to one, it's just one of these types of things where it's like you talk to a hologram for a little bit and you don't actually go in anywhere. Like, I always thought it'd be cool if you could actually like visit like a city part, like actually see people
yeah
walking around and stuff. Like, there wouldn't be any real point to it, because it's like, you know, unless they added like a different system to the game where you could like, you know, buy goods or something. But I'd rather it be where like, you know, everything has a function rather than just something to kind of like, you know, fill out the world in a way.
Yeah.
Like, it is nice to be able to kind of have that immersion, but at the same time, it's like, yeah, there should be a functional purpose to it, because otherwise it's like they're going to work so hard on this one thing that most people are never going to need to see. Kind of like the Mother Base, like visiting Mother Base in Metal Gear Solid 5.
Oh, yeah.
Like, it's cool that you can go there, but there's literally no reason to. You know? So. Yeah, so every time you connect a new thing, it'll show where other players' structures are, and it'll also allow you to construct your own structures in that area. So it has to be connected to the network in order for you to build structures.
Okay.
Oops.
Oh, you forgot. No.
Thank you, Sam.
Sip. I'm kind of skip you. Yeah, cool. Uh-huh.
Bring them online is what he's saying.
Yep. Got it. Yep.
Two new orders.
We sip.
So now you can craft shit.
Wow.
Do the construction post box one, two. Yeah, do both of them. Except. Just hold X because. Oh, unless they want you to make a PCC. Alright, fabricate a PCC. Right there. Yes. Yes, I'll tell you everything he's gonna tell you. Okay. Hit X. Select one. Hold X. Uh-huh. Load it.
Oh, fuck.
Just load everything, because you gotta take that shit to the other guy anyway.
Yeah. Okay.
Carry PCC. Yep, doesn't matter. Alright. And unless you want to drop anything off, because you probably don't need four ladders. I would maybe take two.
Yeah.
Like if you hit square, go back. If you hit square, you can select multiple. So I would put two away. So hit that. Hit X. Nope. So select two ladders again. Hit X and then put place in private locker. And now you can hold it to get.
There we go.
Nope. Hold X. Yeah, it's kind of finicky the first few times you do the menus.
Yeah, it's the weird like holding X and all that.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. Sam, assuming you've got your PCC in order, so they want you to go to. They want you to go to that zone that he designated there in front of you, and that's where he wants you to build the post boxes right there.
Right here.
Yeah. It seems kind of arbitrary that they want you to build it right there, but that's where he wants you to do it.
Okay.
I only say do that because I think you get some likes out of it and shit, so. And then that way it's a decent, you know, kind of introduction to how, like, this system of the game works. It's not hard to understand, but.
Fuck.
I'm sorry. I like how violent the fucking trip animation is. It's ridiculous. Before the night's out, I actually want to try. I wanted to try something in my save file. Maybe we can load it up and see. I wanted to try something. Just to have some fun with it. Later on, there's this carrier that you can get. It's like that little, like, thing that follows behind you carrying stuff.
Okay.
You can stand on it and like use it like a skateboard, which is kind of fun. Like you can't ride it everywhere. Like yeah. It's only really good if you go like downhill. So later on I want to try going up to like the top of a fucking mountain and doing that down it.
Okay.
I think that would be fun. Like, there's a good spot that I'm thinking of that we could try. Sam. Hopefully my save file is still on here. Or, like, we can still load it anyway. Yeah, so you equip it. L2 to ready it. And then you can adjust where you do it, and then just hit R2 to build. There you go. Simple as that.
Nice.
Yeah, so you get some easy likes out of it. Like, why not, you know?
My own shit, no.
Sweet.
Right. So now I need to go to
left. Yeah, there.
That guy. Alright, so
basically if you follow the river it'll take you right there.
Sounds good to me.
Ooh, what's that?
What, up
if
there?
You no to the left, that tower thingy. That you see right down in front of you, right there.
Oh.
If you hold L1, you can, and you hold R3, you can zoom in and out a little bit, like just to kind of zoom. I think you can do it in third person too, you can zoom in, but can be a little bit helpful just to kind of like scan the environment a little bit.
Resins.
So that's a material. If you want it, you can take it. If not, you don't have to. They're a big part later in the game. Like I said, if you want to construct the roads and the highways, you need a fuck ton of materials. And I really do mean a fuck ton. Mostly metals and ceramics are the two that you need. And also those little like hand thingies that you can't pick up yet.
Mm-hmm.
Those are chiral crystals. You need a fuck ton of those too.
So I need to get on this side of the river.
Somebody left a ladder there.
Yeah, that's just about to...
Yeah. That's another player's ladder. Look at that.
Wow.
Drop him some likes. That is kind of a nice system that, like, I like how that there's no... I forget who else brought it up. Somebody else said it, but they're like... they like how there's no dislike thing. You can only like stuff. Like, it's just positive reinforcement. Which is kind of fun. Yeah, once the time goes up, you can't like anything.
Oh, okay.
It's okay. Don't worry about it. He dismantled it. Why'd you do that?
Because I'm an asshole.
Well, like I said, I think that only affects your game. I don't think it's...
Yeah.
It affects anybody else.
I like to think that it doesn't, though. That it only affects, only affects other people.
And it affects everyone.
Is this a boogity-boo? Can't pick it up.
Yeah, you can't pick that one up yet.
I'm going down, down, double, double, double. Why is my life showing?
I think you know why.
Did I hurt myself?
No.
Why is there a pole here? I don't like it, it's beeping.
Heads up, Sam. Your cargo's been pinged. Move.
Oh, God.
Before someone has eyes on you.
That's those fuckers.
You're praying right at him. Now, the first time I encountered these guys, I was afraid and I ran from them. That is an option. There's a tall grass to the left and right there in front of you. Keep going the way you're going. No, there's tall grass right there. You can hide in it. That is an option if you crouch. However, these first few enemies, they're really not that bad. So if you go up to them, like, the combat is actually a lot of fun because, like, of how kind of, like, scrappy it is.
Mm-hmm.
These earlier enemies, like, I think you can see some of them. If you paint or, like, you do your scan... Like, you can tag them. So, like, those orange thingies there are the guys. That's the cargo that they're carrying. The mule boots. Calling them out. these are opening enemies are actually not too bad. Because they have, like, these little spear thingies that you can use. But if you go, So, hand-to-hand combat works pretty nicely. But one thing that you can also do is if you hold right on the D-pad and you go in your inventory, you have the strand that you can use, the rope. That's infinite. You have infinite of those. And they're so simple to use because you can either stealth up and sneak up on behind somebody and tie them up.
Mm-hmm.
Or if you're in combat, if you ready it, you can do like a parry and tie them up. And the parry window is huge. So like, it's actually not too hard to do combat in this game. And also, if you say you knock out a guy, you can grab their cargo and you can hit people with it too.
Oh, nice.
So like, there's a couple different tactics for that. So if you go up to somebody unarmed and start mashing square, you'll punch them, which works just fine usually. But also, if you say you pick up cargo with R2 and you're holding R2, if you hit square, you'll swing it at them and you can hit people with it, which is usually like an instant KO. Or even better yet, if you hold cargo using R2, and then you hit square to swing. If you let go of R2 mid-swing, you'll throw it at people. Oh. It's actually really cool. So there's like a few different options for like hand-to-hand combat. So don't feel like if you get caught by these guys that you're totally like screwed, because they're actually not that hard. Oh, somebody's red. They're red. They see you. They see you.
Ooh.
Oh. All right. Well.
Excuse me.
Somebody is a little bit more accurate than I thought they would be.
Ooh.
Go. So yeah, those little rod things are the scanner things. Obviously, I was just kind of letting you figure that out. It is pretty sweet, though, like, when they're chasing you. Like, it is actually kind of fun. Are they behind you? Are, like, they right on you? No, he's not. They're still a little ways off. He's coming, though. He's coming right up at you.
Thanks, dude.
That looks so cool. The fuck is happening?
I don't know.
Oh, it's a cutscene. I'm like, what the fuck happened? Because it's raining.
You're like, no, don't rain.
Why are they running and jumping like that?
I thought you broke something at first. I don't know what the fuck. Excuse me. God damn. The combat is actually pretty fun, though. Yeah, if you do it, like, it kind of becomes a little bit of a trivial thing later.
Yeah.
Especially if you get once you have more options for combat, because you do have the option to fabricate weapons later. But it's fun. It's still cool. Like, it is fun because of how, like I said, how scrappy it is. Like Sam is obviously not a combatant so much.
Yeah.
So his, you know, melee skills are pretty,
a little lackluster.
Yeah, they're not great. But a little simple. That's kind of what makes it fun, though, is that, like, it's in character for him.
I didn't ask for this.
It's not fucking Jaden.
No, Adam Jensen.
Yeah, Jensen, that's right.
To this shit. Whoa!
And they got these scanners all over the place, don't they?
Yeah, they do. I mean, it's not like they're going to come after me if I set it off, because it's raining.
I think there's a base over there to the left, like right dead in front of you. Dead to head. You see it? Yeah, that one right there. That's not the one you're going to, but that is one. That's Jeff Keighley, I think.
Hi, my name is Jeff Keighley.
You know who Jeff Keighley is, right? You remember him?
Nope.
He's the host of the... that's the... Now you're out of the network, so you can't construct anything now.
Okay. And that's where I gotta go, so I might as well...
Jeff Keighley is the host of the Video Game Awards.
Oh, yes. Okay.
I don't think there's anything you can do for him right now, but you might as well go over there and see if there's anything that... That makes sense. But at least you know he's here. That's he's Luden's fan. That's his name. Oh, maybe it's not even open yet. Nope, it's not even open. So never mind. You can't talk to him. That's alright. He's optional, too. You don't even have to talk to him the entire game. Excuse me.
You are excused.
So, Billy, we're about... Like 3 hours into this game.
I hate it.
What do you think?
I hate it. It's not bad. It's nifty.
It's interesting. It's different, right? Like, it does take some time to get into the game. Like, I've heard some people say that the game doesn't really get going until episode 3. And I would say, like, yeah, I can kind of agree with that, but maybe even, like, a little bit after that. The game doesn't really show you what it's all about until, like, episode 4.
Why do I have boots?
3 or 4.
Why do we have boots?
Because the lower left meter, like, your boots are wearing out. So if another pair of boots, you can carry... You can carry up to 2 extra pairs of boots on the boot clip. And when he shakes it around like that, that's his, I guess, allergy or some shit for the BTs coming out. This whole thing I get tired of, too. Like, the little animation that's got to play every time that they're around.
Yeah.
I get it. I think it's, like, loading them into the area, but it's still kind of annoying that every single time you have to watch it, like, you can't skip that. Kind of dumb. Yeah, if you click R3, you can see, through the other side. Although, I think they added it in an update that you could see the scanner through your cargo, I think. It's kind of there. Not really, though. I usually switch to the other shoulder. There you go. Yeah, they don't tell you. I don't think they ever tell you at any point that if you stand still, you see them. Oh, yeah, you can also do it in first person. Actually, first person is not a bad thing, because when you crouch, you actually move faster in first person than you do in third person. So you're walking straight into one. There you go. That's good. Nice work. Yeah, just be aware of where you're going. Alright, you should be good. Yeah, once it starts, like, spinning in a circle, that's when you're, like, danger close, you know?
Yeah.
When it's doing this open-close thing, like, you're usually at a good distance. That's when it kind of gets a little close, like, when it starts spinning like that. Yeah. There you go, man. Do you have to go up that? I don't know if you have to. Probably go. I think there's a way right around here. There you go.
And I'm out of BT territory. Oh.
Those glasses look awful. You get another pair of glasses later if you do, like, the right side quests and shit. It doesn't look so hot. And I like them a lot more.
He might be hungry.
No, he needs blood. Autotoxemia. That's what happens if his stress levels get, like, or his stamina gets too low. Like, he won't be able to detect BTs for you anymore.
Oh, that's fine. I don't even need him.
See, you can do a double jump.
That's not how it works, though.
And try it. And you have to be running fast enough. Whatever. You'll have other opportunities to do it. Yeah, you have to have, like, enough momentum to do it.
Oh, sweet. Doom buggy.
The battery's dead on it. You can't use it yet. No shit! Probably double jump here. Nope. What the fuck, game? There you go. Yeah! They don't tell you that. That's just one of those little things they do not tell you about in this game. There's a couple things like that they just don't tell you about. It's kind of dumb.
Hard West.
Huh?
They're singing.
Why does everyone have a fucking Santa hat?
Because they're near Christmas.
By the time these videos go up, it's not going to be Christmas anymore.
No.
If you're watching this during Christmas, Merry Christmas. Or Hanukkah.
If you're watching it after, fuck you.
You don't believe in the Christmas spirit.
Mm. Oh, that's good dick. Oh, fuck.
Whatever happened to Pepsi Fire, man?
It wasn't good.
Do they even still make that?
Oh, I doubt it.
I had it that one time you had it at your place, and it was not... You
know, it was not good.
Not great.
I think they still have some of it. What is time?
You can skip this now. We've already seen this.
Oh, good. Skip.
It's him floating and doing the thing. Boss, whatever. Skip. You know, it's fucking dumb. That's what I mean. There's so many cutscenes like that you can just, you know...
Oh, my... I burped it and went in my nose.
So the point, too, is, like, I guess that thing at the top, the big number, the 200 out of whatever.
Yeah, 2,320.
Yeah, they're, that's how much bandwidth you have. So the more places you get online, like, the more bandwidth you get, and the more bandwidth means, like, that's how much you can construct, or how many, like, things, like, structures you can build. Nice. So each structure you build takes up bandwidth. So go to the private room. Rest in private room. Yes.
Those glasses are terrible.
Those glasses are the worst. I think they look dumb just by themselves. Like, I don't care what color they are. They look stupid. Do you look like you're a fucking member of Slipknot or something?
My baby. My baby.
I think
a saxophone player or Slipknot.
I think it's funny. I remember watching an unboxing video of like the deluxe edition for this game or whatever, and it comes with like a true life replica size of the container with the baby in it. Mother. And it's got the baby in it. Located in the capital, not city, ICU.
Brendan, of course. You mean still mother?
Correct. A still mother's womb facilitates a connection between the world of the dead and the BB. And you, in turn, connect yourself to a BB, granting you the ability to sense BTs.
Thank you.
These pods were designed to simulate the conditions inside a still mother's womb. BBs need to believe they're in all times to function properly. However, we can only maintain this deception for so long, which is why we must periodically update the environmental data by synchronizing it with the steel mother via the chiral network.
Via the internet.
There. The update is in progress. Right now the pod is synchronizing with the steel mother in Capital Knot City and reconfiguring its settings based on the latest data.
All right.
Returning your pretty metal to the womb in this manner will temporarily reduce its stress levels. That being where it technically belongs, of course.
Kid looks happy.
I'll try adjusting the oxytocin passage. Oxytocin will shift steadily much slower than now on.
You look like such a douche.
Try not to get attached. Each one has been physically removed from its steel mother's womb, a process that renders them unpredictable, prone to failure. No BB on record has remained in service for over a year. It may need to be retired before this expedition is over.
You're saying there's no way to keep my BB alive?
You must understand. There is still a great deal we don't know about BBs.
Are they just little white pellets you shoot out of a gun?
In one world, yeah, not in this one, though.
You asked me to look into why the BTs might be reacting to your blood. I spoke with Hartman. We should have your results soon.
Oh, fuck yeah, that's good.
Anyway, get some rest. You and your BB are both exhausted.
Don't tell me what I am.
How the fuck do you know?
You don't fucking know me, man. Goodbye, you fucking hologram bitch. Fuck you.
Would you lose some weight?
Yeah. Maybe make your hologram lose some fucking
weight. Yeah. Thanks to my Chinstrap Chaps, fucking Jenny Craig. Mm-hmm.